ancestors at different places on earth. So that is an event which is buried so much, so remotely in the past, and of which very little evidence is so far available to us, that I cannot certainly say when it happened and who it was. Because the scientists who have been discovering the various fossilized or otherwise preserved specimens of early man are still in the process of trying to figure out how far ago life started, and wherever on earth it started. Did it start simultaneously in different places, or did it follow a single line? So because the knowledge is limited so far, I can't answer you on that end. Now this question seemed to be beyond your capacity to understand the answer, and I didn't see any recognition on your face either. So, have I been talking to Deadwood? Did you understand the answer? I hope so. No. Or as you should have told me, please stop. Thank you very much anyway. You have been instrumental in enlightening others, I hope. One sound.
As if today scholars, some Muslim scholars, yes, they believe and they write that Islam was spread by the might of sword, and they bases this argument on one of the hadiths, which narrates that once when non-believers or the Jews they waged a war against Muslims, Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he commanded Hazrat Ali and handed him a sword and said that go and fight them until they all become Muslim. So we find this a little bit confusing here.
I have discussed this subject in detail in my book Murder in the Name of Allah, particularly rejecting the Maududi stance on this issue. So if you have read that book, this question shouldn't have arisen. People, unfortunately, do not understand the true meaning of this teaching and why Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam at times said this. Now to begin with, to make it clearer to those who are not well versed with the Quranic teaching and the exposition of that teaching in words or in practice by Hazrat Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, let me pose a question. If it was essential for Islam to be spread by sword until people accepted, they should have been either killed or imprisoned or something should have been done, then why didn't Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam initiate this? Why didn't he order his followers to start murdering all the people in Medina until they believed? Do you have the slightest evidence to that? None whatsoever. So what you're talking is it is a war situation, and a war situation where offensive was initiated without fail by the enemy, where through treachery those Jews you're talking about had already forfeited their right to live, because their own religious teaching had made it absolutely clear that if you come into covenant with the people and you break that covenant, the punishment for that treachery is murder and nothing but murder, but killing by sword, you know, subjecting you to sword. So according to their Sharia, this was the answer. According to Islam, traitors who despite being obliged not only by religion but by common norm must not betray the cause of a people against whom a war is waged. they must be killed because of that crime. This is something which in fact has not a religious foundation. It has a foundation in human common universal understanding. All over the world, this is the answer. So the question is not why Rasulullah ordered them to be killed. The question is why he gave them quarter under some condition. That is the only question which should be understood. And Rasulullah gave this quarter only because God had prohibited killing of a Muslim by a Muslim. So even if during the state of war somebody genuinely accepted Islam, his life would become sacred. So it has a completely different connotation. No war was waged, never, to spread Islam. But if during any war anyone becomes a Muslim, then Muslims have no right over his soul, over his life, because we don't know whether he is genuine or not genuine. You can never rule out the possibility that such a man genuinely accepted Islam. So if he did so, he should be given a fair trial, fair chance to act according to Islamic teachings and save his soul. So it is out of that special mercy that Rasulullah always said, according to the teachings of the Quran, that even if during the war somebody becomes a Muslim, take your hands off. You have no right to kill such a man. So spread of Islam through compulsion is something else. Seeking shelter under Islam by an enemy who had forfeited his life is a completely different thing. So that is why once during a battle, when a renowned warrior, a stalwart of the idolaters who was fighting against the Muslims from their side, when he was finally defeated and overpowered, and when the Muslim warrior was about to kill him, he declared La ilaha illallah, and that was all. He didn't even say Muhammad Rasulullah. He knew only one thing, that the Muslims have such regard for the unity of God. So he said, La ilaha illallah. This Muslim warrior who had overpowered him responded by saying, you can't cheat me. I know you are trying to save your life. That is why you say this. And he killed him. When he reported this matter to Rasulullah Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was so angry that he went on repeating a sentence continuously for quite some time. Halla shakakta kalbahu, halla shakakta kalbahu. Why didn't you open up his chest first and peeped inside to find out whether he was honest about it or not? Now, the reporter of this narration tells us that he wished he had not become a Muslim till that moment, so that he could not go through the suffering which he experienced by causing such pain to Rasulullah. The pain he caused to Rasulullah was so agonizing for him that, referring to it, he said, I wished before this I had not become a Muslim. And the same person is reported to have said something else as well in another narration. He says, then Rasulullah Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, who would stand between you and the kalima which he recited on the day of judgment? That is to say, that kalima would accuse you on the day of judgment. That there was a person who began to believe in the unity of God, and yet he was murdered on the suspicion that he may be false.